Go.
Okay, welcome. Today we're going to have a small introduction about OpenCV, and I have a couple of slides for you guys to just go a brief introduction, who are you, overview on the functions in OpenCV and what. So, my name is Mohamed Al-Akhoumi. I'm a PhD candidate. Okay, so first, this is kind of like what we're going to go through, just a small introduction. What is OpenCV, and why do we need OpenCV? Go through some applications, some examples that we have. We're going to go through the functions of some functions, main functions in OpenCV, and then we have a nice exercise for you guys, and then there's some references in the, at the end of the presentation for you to go if you need more information about OpenCV. So OpenCV is an Open Computer Vision Library. That's what it stands for. And it was developed by Intel starting in 2000. That project started in 2000, and then it went through some stages. And then they came up with the first OpenCV version 1.0, and then developed it. And now we're actually at version 2.1. That's the one that you have installed and you're going to do the exercise. Basically, over 500 image processing functions. Very interesting functions, very important functions that you don't need to actually go and write the code for the whole function and then link it back. You have your library, the OpenCV library, you can just basically use all the functions present in it. The platforms that it supports, Windows and Linux, certainly. And with the new version, it has more support for Mac, because prior, I guess, the first version maybe did not support Mac that much. Now they have a very well-developed platform for Mac operating system. The three languages that can use this library for the time being, I guess, directly linked to C, C++, and Python. My knowledge is very limited on Python, and of course, I guess most of you are familiar with C++, C, C++. Everyone familiar? Because the exercise is basically C++, so I'm hoping that...
Okay, I was thinking that you guys should stop because...
No problem. That's recording. So, basically, it's... as I mentioned, it's a library, so you install it, and then you use it with your Visual Studio program, so it's not a programming unit on its own, but it's used with C++, for example, as you will see in your exercise. So why OpenCV? Of course, the most important thing is saving time. As you can find your code, just going and using all these functions that are available for you, rather than implementing all of that. Of course, it's a big thing, especially in C++. You're going to have many lines of code for some, you know, straightforward functions. Real-time computer vision algorithms are possible with OpenCV. There are a lot of functions that you use in real-time. So, for example, you're capturing real-time video. You input your video to your program, and then you apply some image processing functions, and you can see the output in real-time. So, yes?
What's the base of the OpenCV based on the MATLAB?
Well, speed. First, second, MATLAB. I guess OpenCV is open source, so it's free. That's one thing. It's also
it's been working for video, I think.
For video, yeah, it's much simpler, I think. I tried to use MATLAB, but then
work with the Microsoft Visual Studio.
Yeah, for example, or Python if you want. These are the two main things. Yeah. Not implemented with MATLAB like these functions. So, and again, it's open source, so you just go and download the free version, and that's the only version present. So let's go deeper actually in how the building blocks of OpenCV is. And we have OpenCV modules that are CV, CV Auxiliary, CV Core, CX Core, sorry, and High Graphical User Interface. And we will go through each one of these and give some examples on the functions used for each of these. But let's have a kind of a visual of where we stand. And basically, you have your code that you're implementing in all your C++, for example. You have your sample code. And then that goes actually and linked directly to the CV and the CV auxiliary modules and to the machine learning library, the graphical user interface library, and all of these actually are linked down to the CSX port, and that's where all your like main functions are, for example, matrix modifications, any computations, and all these simpler functions that implement the three higher modules. And then you go into deeper actually from CX port to the IPP, and that's the integrated performance primitives, and that's basically just your code from CX core going into an interface to your CPU. So it's kind of like an optimized code as it's written there for Intel CPUs. So it's easier for the CPU to handle the code that you are basically connecting. AMD. Not sure. No idea. Okay, so most of the functions, as you will see, start with CV, and that's how you know mainly that it is a CV function, a computer vision library function. So, for example, you have CV named window and CV capture from file, etc. You have to be aware that which modules you are trying to use in your code, and sometimes you will need more than other times. You might only need CV.edge, for example, only that module, or the CX port, or usually the IUI when you're doing any image and video. So just make sure when you're kind of writing your code to know what to include in the code. So we'll start with CX port, and that's basically, as I said, it's the main functions. Very simple example is just defining a point, CV point, and it's just a 2D point that you can input the coordinates for it. Another thing is, for example, the IPL image, and that's also another type. Remember, it's a type, it's not a function. It comes from the Intel image processing library, and that's where it got its name, IPL, image processing library. So it was used before, and then they kind of like took it and wanted to implement it in OpenCV. It's actually a little different in the way that it is implemented. It does not implement 100% of all what IPL image type does for the Intel image processing library. So, but mainly it kind of have the same idea. That's how you define your, for example, the pointer to your image, and then use that when you load an image or try to use the image that you have. So, some other functions, CV load and CV save, just save or load any objects from a file that you have. Now let's go to the high graphical user interface functions. And the first function, we mentioned this one before, CV named window. So basically, when you're trying to have a graphical interface, you're trying to create some kind of a window to show your output or what you have done to your input or whatever you want to show. And basically, you can show an image or you can show a video. But this is an example of a simple image of an apple. So you basically just input that image and then you create a window. And that window, you specify the window name because you're going to probably use it when you want to show the image. And then you specify the size. You can leave it as auto size, and that basically what it does is that it just takes the size of the image and automatically adjusts to that size and show you that image. So that's basically what CV name window is. And also you can create it to display images and track bars. There are some examples actually in OpenCV. You can probably go and look it up. There are some examples that you use track bars, for example, to increase or decrease some thresholds on your image to filter out some noise or do something like that on the image. You can certainly create some track bars on these windows automatically. itself. CV show image, basically just, you know, you put the image out there, put it on in the window. So you just specify the window name that you have created and then the image that you are trying to output on that window. So another function is the CV load image, and that's when you are trying to you have your image file on your computer and you're trying to load it into some variable that you have specified. So for CV load image does that for you. So you have your pointer to your image that's gonna be the one that's gonna take that file and store it in it. So you input for it, you input the file name, and then you input some kind of a flag. This is optional, I believe, so you can just load the image itself from the file. There's no need to actually put that flag, but I just put it there for you to have an idea that you can also specify how many channels your color image is. The CV save image is the vice versa of load. Just you have your image and you want to save it on your computer, and again, you specify your file name and your image. The CV wait key, this is a very important function. Usually you use it almost all the time in your OpenCV code, and basically what it does is that you just put a delay for some time, and usually you use it very often in the high GUI, is that you want to do an infinite delay of how long your code will be running, for example, when you open that window. So you want that window to be there for a long time, so usually you just set it at zero and just run infinitely until the user himself wants to close that window, then they will do that. These are more functions for capturing video. Basically, the first one is the CV capture from camera, and this is when you attach your webcam to your computer and you're getting live video from that, and you want to capture that live video, so you just put in that function and then you assign the camera ID. Usually when you put it zero, it goes to default, that's the first webcam that you have, and it assumes that that's, I guess usually you only have one webcam. I think I use one time two, and then when you assign zero and then you assign one, it goes from one to another. So, but usually, you know, people just have one webcam. So it initializes capturing from the specified camera, and then you can use that video, you can grab some frames, you can do whatever you want to the video and output it or put something on it. CV capture from file is basically kind of just loading your you're trying to initialize capturing from a video file that you have on your desktop. Query frame, CV query frame, if you remember this, we had some problem at we preferably use CV query frame for this purpose, to retrieve the next video frame. This is very important if you're using any functions that you have to have your image and then look on the next frame or back and forth between two frames, and usually you use that very common in a lot of image processing techniques. You have the CV release capture, and that's when you want to release your the video. So you always want to release the resources that you are using. Even when you create a window, you want to kind of destroy that window at the end of your code. When you're trying to capture.